Now we have spent some time exploring clouds, we can apply what we learned to our game art. In this video, we are going to see how we can draw clouds in pixel art. I recommend that you spend time analyzing the work of experienced pixel artists to make some of their techniques yours. Pixel art is a particular art form. It requires you to abstract and stylize reality greatly. You only have squares at your disposal to draw any kind of shape. You can explore the art direction of games like Super Time Force, Dungeon of the Endless, the good old Metal Slug, or you can focus on the art of specific artists. I'm really fond of Sioza's work, for instance. The more detailed your assets are, the more they will be visible to the eyes of the player. Clouds are mostly meant to be background elements. They shouldn't look too sharp and saturated compared to gameplay assets. Most of the time, the clouds we're going to draw in pixel art will be faint. In Sword and Sorcery, they are really soft and desaturated. Note that they are not really made in pixel art though. This is something you often see in recent pixel art games. Developers tend to mix an old-school style with soft gradients and modern visual effects. You can find beautiful clouds in the game Oldboy. They are less saturated and contrasted than the foreground, which is vibrant and detailed. The demo from 2011 is filled with gorgeous environment art, by the way, that's a great reference. With that in mind, it's time to draw our own clouds. As always, we are going to start by collecting a handful of references that are relevant to our game's needs. I'm using PureRef to create a ball that I'll leave on my second screen while painting. With pixel art, you're going to zoom in a great deal on your document to place those pixels accurately. At the same time, you will need to constantly check if your art is working at 100 or 200% sizes. To answer that need, I invite you to duplicate your document. You can keep a floating copy of your canvas that will stay zoomed out the whole time. To do that with Photoshop, you have to go to the Window menu, Arrange, and select the last option, New Window for the active document. Before we draw anything, we have to define our sunlight's direction to ensure that we stick to it afterwards. In a side-scrolling game, we have to pick a primary light source that we will reuse throughout the whole adventure. The sunlight often comes from the top and a bit from the left. This convention helps to direct the player's eyes to the right. Okay, now that our document is set up, it is time to start drawing pixel art. We are going to start with the sky. For now, it's going to be a gradient. We can make one using the gradient tool. To simulate a daylight sky, I'm picking a saturated light blue as the bottom of the gradient and a darker shade for the top of it. This is not a pixel art sky. Later in the drawing process, we can redo it and give it some texture. In this video, however, we are focusing on clouds. The gradient is here to replace the 2, 3 or 4 sky colors that we would have had if we drew the sky manually. The next step consists of blocking the cloud's silhouette. I'm already thinking about the cloud's shading at that point. I'm starting with the shadow tone, which corresponds to a desaturated version of the sky's color. In the previous video, I gave some rhythm or movement to my cloud's silhouette. This is fine if you want your cloud to pop in a picture. However, as a background element, this shouldn't look too unique, especially if you are going to duplicate the clouds in your levels. To ensure that they stay in the background, you can make their overall silhouette fit in a single concave shape. Your clouds can look flat or fluffy, but their overall silhouette should be simple to start with. I'm drawing cumuli. They have a lot of round forms to them. I'm also doing a small composition, not a single cloud. Those are not meant to be duplicated or animated in-game. They are meant to just sit in the background, as in Chasm or Oldboy. Once the silhouette works well enough, it is time to add a lighter color on a new layer clipped at our base. Here, I'm directly picking the lightest shade of the clouds, a color that's close to white. As they'll be in the background, I don't want to give them small and shiny highlights beyond that. You can apply this light tone to all of the parts of the clouds that are more or less facing the sun. You can be loose for now, as we will be refining our clouds later. Right now, the transition between the shadow and the light tone is a bit abrupt. That is where our transition tone comes in. Here, I'm just applying the shadow tone with an opacity of 50% over the light tone. Then, I'm putting back the pencil tool to 100% opacity and I'm drawing with that color over the shadows. Why only there? Because I defined the inner form of the clouds using the light color. I want to retain those details to build upon them later. When the cloud shapes feel okay, it is time to merge all three layers together and to work with a smaller brush. At that point, I'm going to look at every round form on the 100% size document and assess whether or not it looks coherent. I am trying to think about what each inner curve means. If some forms are too aligned with one another or do not suggest a round volume, I'm going to break them up. Anything that looks like a big pattern in your clouds should be broken down, as it will make it look unnatural. However, your shapes shouldn't look too erratic either. We are trying to define natural, round masses here. An organized chaos in a sense, as it's often the case with nature. You should also let your eyes bounce often between the zoomed-in document and its copy. It is critical to see how well pixel art is working at its normal zoom level. Last but not least, throughout the process, you can change your color scheme. It doesn't have to be set in stone. I'm using vibrance, hue, saturation, and levels to fine-tune the colors. When your cloud's volumes are well-defined, it is time to move on and refine them. This is one of the most time-consuming tasks as far as pixel art is concerned. The idea is to look at every single shape that makes up our piece and to improve its outline, pixel by pixel. Once again, we are going to start with the bigger silhouettes and move our way down to the smaller ones. In other words, we are going to look at the overall silhouette of our clouds and then at the silhouette of each color island. The light, the shadow, and the transition colors all deserve some care. The goal is to make every curve in our piece more consistent. This doesn't necessarily mean rounder, which is tricky. We are looking to break up straight lines that might be hidden in our design, but also to make the pixel patterns our outlines follow more consistent. To produce a clean curve in pixel art, you want to create a gradation of the amount of pixels you are moving forward for one pixel to the side. And you want to avoid straight diagonals as much as possible, especially if they are more than 4 pixels long. During the refining phase, you have to nudge pixels around, see which combination works best. It is a slow process. At that stage, you can put some nice music in the background and let your mind abandon itself to the piece. This is almost a zen exercise. You are trying to perfect the balance of every one of your shapes. And there is no magic formula to get those curves right. At some point, I used a black color overlay to better see the changes on the silhouette. But apart from that, I am just constantly looking at the zoomed out document to see how each change affects it. I do have a small tip for you to wrap this up though. The less contrast there is between two colors, the less visible your shape's imperfections will be. So here, what matters the most is the cloud's light side that's clashing against the sky. That's it for today. In a future tutorial, we'll focus on the techniques we can use to create neat curves in pixel art. It is one of the toughest constraints you face with this art, so don't worry if you can't get it right for now. If you like the video, you can click on that like button, become a subscriber to support the channel, or share it with your friends. I want to thank you all for watching. Be creative, have fun, until next time.